Hello, my name is Henry Franco. I'd like to introduce you to John. He's my new client. As you can see, John has a full head of hair with a sweeping movement to it. So what we're going to be using some of our Chitai products and some of our tools to relieve some of the bulk and maintain that nice flow that we have here.
I can see that John's hair is coarse and it's wavy and it has that little natural curl to it. But the coarseness of his hair, I would use a wide tooth comb, and then I would use a little bit of the Chitai Blade Glide to work the hair a little bit easier. In order to be able to create around the ear, you have to pull it over in front, and then you're doing like a question mark. You're making like a question mark coming around the ear. The Feather Switchblade Shears Model 75, the unique feature of this scissor is the blades are disposable, so when it gets dull, you can switch out the blade, and there is a lifetime guarantee on the frame. She wants a longer look, and so what we're going to do here is section his hair off in different sections. Now I'm going to be working with the planes and front planes up there, as you can see. So now we're overextending. The overextending meaning pulling in the opposite direction. We're pulling the hair in the opposite direction in order to maintain the hair to come back, because we want to maintain the fullness of it. Pulling it to, say, a 45 degree angle, pulling it back up, and then you're going to be cutting on a 45. You have that tendency to cut it too short, so you have to overextend in order to make it come back. It grows a quarter inch per month, so you're looking, if you cut an inch off, you have almost 4 months worth of hair, because you're only getting about a quarter of an inch per month. He wants to really maintain the fullness. He wants a real long look. Well, you're not gonna go in and cut 2 inches off. You're not gonna go and cut 1 inch off. You're gonna go in and cut a quarter of an inch off. If you wanted to cut it shorter, you'd still be cutting it on a 45, but you wouldn't be doing the overextension. You wouldn't be pulling the opposite direction, because you've overextended it. You won't have that tendency to cut it short, but still taking into consideration that you have to cut it on the planes of the head. I'm working with those planes up in the front right there. And then by extending the hair over, now I'm gonna cut it on a 45. By me standing in that position and maintaining that position, I'm always gonna get that same cut. I'm not moving. You gotta stay in position, which I'm going through the front frontal, then I'm going through the side, and then I'm working my way all the way to the back. So now what we're going to do is line these lines up. Okay, remember we hit pull forward. You're looking for the balance all the way through in a haircut. You're not just cutting, okay? You're looking for balance. The balance of a haircut is where it's full all the way through and it's maintained and it has that flowing look. So when this haircut is said and done, this whole haircut would fall in. Doesn't matter which direction he combs it or how he wants to comb it, it's all balances out. Leave a little bulkiness out in there. You could come in and pull that bulkiness out with the razor also. The DX models have all stainless steel, heavier in weight, and have more balance. And all the razors have a detachable blade holder. John has a little bit of wave and I want to smooth it out just a little bit. So what I'm doing right here is just touching the ends and taking that razor. I'm hitting it just a little bit. Cutting the hair underneath. I'm not cutting on top, I'm cutting on the underneath. So you got the longer end on the top and you got the short end on the bottom. You don't have to put any pressure to it. The weight factor itself does the work. Yours just there to guide the tool. Mainly you probably use about a 30 degree angle to see how my blade is. Some of those are 45s and some of them are 30s. It's just how I make that hair flow back. So as I section the hair off, boom, 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 I'm able to create that smoothness through it and makes that hair so it's not so wavy and it'll lay down a lot better because you're taking off that coarseness because he has coarse hair. Now we're working on the back, okay? And I'm using a thinning shear, just tipping, doing the tips. It'll make his hair easier to comb just by touching the tips of it. I'm still doing the same cut all over again, but I'm doing it on the very ends. This is like the finishing aspects of the haircut. You always do a rough cut, then you gotta come in and do the finishing aspects of it. This is what we're doing on the finishing, as we blow dry the hair out, because once it's dry, you'll see all the different lines. Deboa style brush has a cushion base to give the ability for the teeth to slide through the hair easier, and it has a good weight balance to it. And one of the things that made this brush so popular, it has seamless bristles, so the brush can go smoothly through the hair. The whole point is to have no lines and to have it flow. Every once in a while you'll see that. I'm going back and you see the white tooth comb. I'm just going in and just touching it up. When you blow it out, you'll see those little lines. When you see those lines, those are the spears that are left in the haircut. Little angles that look like a spear. So then you'll come back and touch those spears to make it flow. And once we do that, then we're going to do the shaving. Problem with his beard right here is that he's got it cut way down too low in through here, because it's dropping down into the eye, makes the eye drop down. Okay, so I would pull this up just a little bit, up in through here, then it lifts his whole face up. There's planes on the face also. Everything is a plane, everything is angles in what you're looking at. So you're looking for the balance, what you're looking for. You wanna take the droopiness out of his eye till you bring the line up just a little bit higher and it pulls the eye up. Okay, so you're actually pulling his face up. So when you're looking at him, he's got balance in through his jaw, you've got balance in through his cheeks, so you bring the line up. So then when you look at him on a profile view, he's got the fullness all the way through the beard and it's got that lift to it. And applying the lather, we applied the cream and then I put a cleansing cream on. It's like shampooing the skin. You're taking off that little extra grime that's on your skin to protect the blade. Okay, so then we apply the steam towel. After we've done this, pull it down, pull it back towards you, and then you flip one over the other. Pull it down over the nose, pull it back towards you, and you flip. You don't allow the towel to get cold. What are we trying to do? We're trying to soften up the beard. We're trying to soften up the skin. So now we're going behind the lather and do the cleanup. I come back and I shape it with my comb and pulling it down. And now I'm gonna put the lines in it with my shears. I find it easier to do it this way. That way you can draw. See how I'm drawing? And I come back and I can cut it. You're looking at his jawbone as to where it falls to make it look like the lines continued creating that fullness all the way through. You don't wanna go in blind. Now we've, you know, able to put the line in, and all I have to do is come in with the blade and go up to that line, and that I don't have to guess. ridge, you're just using part portion of the leg. You're using the back portion, which is the heel, and then you use the tip of it, which is the toe. This is steaming. We're gonna cleanse him up. Get the lather off. I'm coming back and just cleaning up, just getting in there with that second shave. We put an astringent on. As you're shaving, sometimes you'll have maybe a little nick or something like this. So you want to take it and cleanse the bacteria off. And once we put the astringent, we've taken all the oils off, so now we got to put the oils back in. And then I put a steamer on to take the excess amount of oil on, because I usually put a little bit more oil on than usual. And then you want to get that excess off. And so you just blot the face. So you're blotting the face. Then you come back and you put the moisturizer in. We're going back and cleaning up around the ears, the nape, after the shave. Clean around the ear, giving that line, cleaning the nape. All you're doing is coming back and putting the finishing touches, okay? Cleaning it up, making it a smoother line, cleaning up the lower hair, and then down around the nape, cleaning that up, and around the ears, right up above the ear. Sometimes the guys have a little bit more hair around the ear. You want to clean it up just a tad. So here I am coming back in. I'm using a pair of thinning shears there because I still want to maintain the fullness of it. But I'm just going in and taking off just a little bit to maintain that fullness in there, taking just a little bit off with the thinning shear. Sometimes a guy's beard's a little fuller in some areas, so you want to thin it down just a tad. Then I come in and just cleaning it up. Blow dry, see how the fullness is. Everything's full, see how balanced it is. Everybody's balanced out. I'm using a wide tooth comb like that, put a little bit of motion to it instead of that real smooth look. A lot of guys don't like that plastic look, that little smooth look. They want a little roughness to it, so you use a wider tooth comb. John, I want to thank you for being with us today. Thank you very much.